Let's calculate now the monthly PMI. But first of all, what is PMI? I'm going to go to Insert and then Shapes. And you have different categories over here. I'm looking for callouts. And I'm going to choose one of these and just draw it. And later on, you can just move. And I'm going to type here. You can format your shape how you want it. So I can go here and I can choose from the available styles, something that I like. PMI is private mortgage insurance. If the borrower does not put down 20%, so you have to put down 20%, then it has to pay this fee. I will include in the description below the video the mortgage insurance link from Wikipedia, where you can see below that this fee is usually 0.14% to 2.24% based on all kinds of factors. And it's also tax deductible, which is really cool, but it's not anymore. It was until 2018. And most people pay the PMI in 12 monthly installments. So we're going to assume that for our example. When you use shapes, just be sure the text is readable. You see here, because I have the 3D shape, I cannot really see the last line, so I'm going to just make it a little bit bigger. Why do we have the PMI? It protects the loaner if the borrower defaults. So let's put over here defaults on the loan. Don't forget to always go to review and check the spelling. It also enables the borrower with less cash to secure a loan. So let's see how we can build this function in Excel. If the down payment here is 20% or more, then the PMI is zero. You do not have to pay this fee. Otherwise, you have to pay this fee. And we have the rate over here, 0.38% times the amount financed. So let's do this. If, there is actually a function called if. So let's double click it and get more help. And as usual, always let's click on help on this function. And let's see some examples. The first one over here, you can see if C2 equals yes, and it explains if C2 equals yes, then return A1, otherwise return A2. So that's pretty straightforward. Let's move on. Let's see another example over here. So if C2 is greater than B2, then return over budget, otherwise return within budget. So this example is very similar to what we have, only we need to have some calculations. So it would probably be if this comparison, then we're going to have zero. We don't have to pay that fee. Otherwise, we make the calculation in Excel. Okay, so here under the logical test, let's compare. If the down payment, which is in E9, is greater than, that's the sign, or equal to, this is how you write it in Excel, greater, and then you put equal, greater or equal to 20%. I'm going to click the 20% in B7. Now remember, this formula is going to be filled down. So B7 will become B8, B9. So let's go ahead and lock it with dollar signs for absolute reference, push F4. Okay, what if it's true? If it's true, if we paid 20%, you put down 20% of the house cost, then we do not have to pay the fee, so let's go ahead and type 0. What if it's not true? Then we do have to pay that PMI. So what is the PMI? In this case, it's 0.38%. I click the number. Again, we fill the formula down, so I remember to lock that number because it's in cell B6. I don't want to have it moved to B7, B8. So let's push F4. Okay, so we got the B6. We need to have that times the rate is 0.38 of, so that's times of what? Of the amount financed. We're not going to pay that forever. We're going to pay that probably for a year. Okay? And I can see the result here is zero. And that's because the first loan, they put down 20.2%. So they don't really have to pay any fees. So let's go ahead and any fees, any PMI fee. And let's go ahead and push OK. Okay, now we're going to double click. And let's check and see if it's correct. Yes. For this loan, it's below 20%, so they have to pay the fee. And for this loan, again, it's below 20%, so they have to pay the fee. So it looks right. Now, let's look at the numbers. If you are going to pay almost $900, and that's per month, that looks like a lot of money. So in 12 months, you're going to pay a lot. So we have over here an error. We forgot to actually account for monthly PMI. What we have here is the total PMI. So let's go ahead and divide by 12. Okay, I'm going back to the formula. And let me show you how you can do it from here. So this is a logical test. Over here, the second argument is when the logical test is true. So when this condition is true. And then if I skip next, I am under value false. Okay, so we have the 0.38% times the amount financed, and now let's divide by 12. So division sign, and then we click on the 12, and we lock that 12. It's in one cell. We don't want that cell to move down. Let's go ahead and push F4 to lock it. Control Enter to stay in the cell. Double click to bring it down. So always check your numbers. Always check if it makes sense. So you can, you know, just make a simple calculation. I have this times 12, and I want to see how much I'm going to pay, how much is going to be this fee. Okay, it doesn't have to be that much. So I'm checking what's, you know, almost up to 1% of the house cost. Okay.